Throughout history, there have been many debates that have divided mankind right down the middle. Is there a God? Capitalism or socialism? Pepsi or Coke? Should pineapple go on pizza? And of course, the one debate that I shall be tackling in this video is Die Hard a Christmas movie? Now, I happen to think that Die Hard is a Christmas movie, and whilst I do not expect that this debate will ever end or go away, in this video I'm going to put forward my reasoning for why I think that Die Hard should be classified as a Christmas movie. Now, before I start, let me just say right off the bat that some of the arguments and points I'm going to make in this video are tenuous at best, and on their own are very easy to pick apart and go, don't think so, but I think you have to take every little thing into account when making an argument like this, and I believe that even without some of the weaker points I'm going to make, there is still enough here to support my original position. So let's start. First of all, and this might seem a bit obvious, it's set on Christmas Eve. Now, this seems like a no-brainer, but let's face it, you can't define any movie as a Christmas movie unless it is set in and around Christmas time, which Die Hard is, so that's that checked off the list. But being set around Christmas time isn't enough. There are other films that are set in and around Christmas time that you wouldn't classify as a Christmas movie. Eyes Wide Shut, for instance. For me, in order to qualify as a Christmas movie, the integral foundations and the entire plot of the film has to hinge and play out in a way that it couldn't have taken place at any other time in the year other than Christmas. So, does Die Hard fulfill this criteria? Well, a group of terrorists take over the Nakatomi Plaza building in Los Angeles in order to break into their safe that contains hundreds of millions of dollars worth of bearer bonds. Breaking into the safe is going to take some time, so in order for them to do this, they need to have hostages, otherwise the police would just burst right in the second they found out. It just so happens that on this night in the Nakatomi Plaza building, they are having their staff Christmas party, which means everybody in the building is on the same floor and pretty much in the same room. Now, had they chosen to do this at another time of year, the building would have either been empty or the staff within the building would have been all over the bloody place, making it almost impossible for them to pull out the heist without alerting the police before they even got started. Also, the second part of the story, the reason that John McClane is in LA is because he's taking Christmas vacation from the New York Police Department to spend Christmas with his wife and kids, which is why he happens to be in the building at the time, but also in a different part of the building. Because he's not expected to be there, the terrorists' plan fails because they haven't taken him into account. Now, you could possibly argue that there's no reason that these events couldn't have taken place at another time of year, but the fact is, by setting the movie on Christmas Eve, it just makes them a lot easier to explain and justify. So for me, Die Hard fulfills that part of the criteria. In my opinion, a Christmas movie also has to contain little details that are in some way symbolic or allegorical or metaphorical references to Christmas or Christianity. Let's start with a simple one, John McClane. His name is John. John has very obvious significance in the Bible, as he's one of the apostles, but also, who is John married to? Holly. Holly being one of the most quintessential symbols of Christmas. It would have only been more perfect if she'd been called Miss L. Toe. In what you could argue is a reference to the Nativity, John McClane is a weary traveller who has travelled from and towards the east bearing gifts. He isn't in search of a newborn king, obviously, but he is looking to save his marriage, so salvation, or possibly even being born again, is definitely part of his story. Again, in a reference that is very similar to that story that happens in the Nativity, one of the hostages is a pregnant woman, obviously, forced to stay the night in less than ideal or comfortable settings and circumstances. Another aspect is that there are certain quotes in the movie that couldn't have been made if Die Hard wasn't set in and around Christmas, such as...
Welcome to the party, pal!
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring except... the four assholes coming in the rear in standard 2x2 cover formation.
Remember, we have left nothing to chance. Get them back! Not mine!
Now I have a machine gun. Ho, ho, ho.
Die Hard, like any good Christmas movie, has a feel-good ending that emphasizes the value of both family and friendship. And also, in the case of Sergeant Powell, it also has the theme of redemption, with him pulling his gun at the end, having not done so since he accidentally shot a child many years ago. Now, even I will admit that I'm stretching it with this next point, but fuck it, in for a penny. In the final confrontation with Hans Gruber, John McClane has a gun taped to his back, and the tape is in the shape of a cross, much like the one our Lord Jesus died upon. A Christmas movie, in my opinion, also needs to include songs and music that are unambiguously Christmas-related, and Die Hard is sandwiched in between two of them. The first one is Let It Snow. Let It Snow is a track that plays at the very end of the movie over the end credits. It does this as well in the second movie. It was sung originally by Dean Martin and was released in 1945. It was Christmas number one that year and was also number one in the Billboard charts throughout January and February of 1946. And yet, despite this, when people hear that song nowadays, they don't think of Dean Martin and they don't even initially think of Christmas. Let It Snow is now a song forever associated with Die Hard. Now keep in mind that Die Hard was released 42 years after the original version of Let It Snow, and I think the fact that Die Hard has become synonymous with that song means that it is also a film that is now forever synonymous and associated with Christmas. However, there is another piece of music that is played at the very start of the movie over the opening credit sequence, and its inclusion is one of the most brilliant pieces of meta-foreshadowing ever. In a moment of brilliant self-awareness, the film actually predicts this whole Was Die Hard a Christmas Movie debate when John's limo driver, Argyle, starts playing Run DMC and McClane says...
Hey, that'll work. Is there any Christmas music?
In that one moment, Die Hard has actually prophesied that we would end up being sat here having this debate about whether or not it's a Christmas movie. The same way that John McClane is sat there having a dispute with Argyle over whether or not Run DMC's song is a Christmas song. Because every argument for and against Die Hard being a Christmas movie could be used for and against the Run DMC song Argyle plays in the limo. And if you think that is a Christmas song, if you think that Run DMC's song is a Christmas song, then it means Die Hard both begins and ends with Christmas songs. And also keep in mind that the Run DMC track is called Christmas in Hollies, which is exactly what John McClane has flown to LA to do in the first place.
I think it's fair to say that those who believe that Die Hard is not a Christmas movie, the crux of their argument is that Die Hard is an action movie that happens to be set around Christmas, but that Christmas is not an integral part of the story. And in theory, you could have set Die Hard to take place at any other time of the year and it wouldn't have made any difference. If that's your position, I have a question for you. Do you think that Home Alone is a Christmas movie? Because as far as I'm aware, nobody has ever tried to argue otherwise. However, I contend that any objection that you could make or have for Die Hard being a Christmas movie, because Christmas is not absolutely essential to the plot or storyline, could also be applied just as easily to Home Alone.
Finally, I'd like to say this. Christmas is really all about tradition. And in order for something to become associated with it, it must ultimately be something that is a reoccurring fixture every year. And whether or not you fall on the Die Hard is or the Die Hard is not a Christmas movie side of the debate, because of the existence of this debate, it means that regardless of what side you happen to take, every Christmas you will end up either watching, talking, or at the very least thinking about the movie Die Hard. And as far as I'm concerned, if you end up constantly associating a movie with Christmas, then that, my friends, is a Christmas movie. My name's Dick Coughlan. Thank you very much. Good night. May God bless.